Okay, so normally we upload the Montreal video at 10 a.m. That's kind of how everything goes. I have a Canadiens video up later today at 12 p.m. PST, but instead we're uploading the Senators video at 10 a.m. PST because I just had to get this one out first. I wanted to talk about this one. I really have a whole bunch of stuff to say because Eugene Melnyk, man! This guy is giving us so much fuel to talk about that it absolutely blows my mind how exactly something like this can even come up. So let's go over onto the Ottawa Sun and take a look at this interview on the article, Eugene Melnyk is in it to win it and confident that the Senators can capture a Stanley Cup. This was uploaded earlier yesterday, and again, it goes over the main claim which we spoke about a few weeks ago, that Melnyk guaranteed the Senators to winning a cup within the next 4 years. That was something that I totally just, I don't know if I want to say roasted is the right word. I kind of critiqued the comment a little bit, but indeed it was said. But this article has a much longer interview with Melnyk, and it's off of the fact that the Senators are celebrating their 30th birthday, which is why there's even this interview to begin with. But we just go over a few bunch of moves made in the past in this interview, and the biggest takeaway, before I even get into the quotes here, is that Eugene Melnyk legitimately just straight up lied, and he admitted that he was lying about all this stuff from the Senators' post-2017 run. It goes over how the Senators made the Eastern Conference Finals against the Penguins. They were in Game 7 overtime. Chris Kunitz came out there. He scored the Game 7 goal, and eventually the Pens went to the finals and they won the cup again. But the Senators, after the 2017 Eastern Conference Finals, kind of fell off. They traded everybody away, they entered rebuilding status, and now they're in a position where you could probably say they're looking better in the long-term future with Tim Stützle, Jake Sanderson, all those guys, etc. But there are indeed some comments over here from Melnyk going over what it was like losing the 2017 final as well as losing the 2007 Stanley Cup Finals. Anytime you win versus losing, it's a much different feeling waking up the next morning and saying, geez, we actually won, and it isn't a great day. To me, it's not just winning that's critical. It's also building a community around the Senators, and that's what we need to do. Take a look at this, though. After acquiring center Matt Duchene from the Avalanche in November 2018 and returning from a successful trip to Sweden, the Sens' fortunes quickly took a turn for the worst. Tough decisions then had to be made. It wasn't easy to accept, but Melnyk and Dorion put in place a plan they felt would pay dividends if people were patient. Nobody's done what I did. I don't care what anybody says. Nobody has gone and gutted a team the way I did. We made a list. The top six guys, they're gone. Show me a team in any sport where the top six guys are gone. This was specifically designed. You had to be a certain age to be a part of it. Okay, first off, what? Top six guys who are gone. Okay, who is that right away? Karlsson, Hoffman, Duchene, Stone, Dzingel, and I guess you could say like Anisimov or something. That's six players over there. Or maybe they're talking about Cody Ceci, who knows? But the point is, the Sens had a plan, and everybody kind of knew that these guys, Karlsson, the Turrises, the Stones, the Hoffmans, they would have been valuable pieces, and that's exactly what they were. It's just, Melnyk at the time, remember all the stuff going on about the trade rumors? They were like, yeah, you know, we want to keep these guys. We want to make sure we win in an environment that's led by guys like Karlsson, Hoffman, Duchene, etc. But let's go back to the comments in this year's time frame. Could we upgrade? On a scale of 1 to 10, we were about an 8 when we lost to Pittsburgh. I think we could have won a Stanley Cup if we had gotten by Pittsburgh. The bottom line was the team itself had to be upgraded, and the only way I felt we could do this, and we took a shot by doing it, was methodically going through the lineup. Melnyk said the organization had taken a lot of flack for not being more open publicly, but he had no choice. He and Dorion didn't want to devalue the assets they were about to move, which meant their only option was to work diligently to get a strong return, and they did. Okay, so right there, that is the important part here. The organization took a lot of flack for not being more open publicly about their plans, but they didn't want to devalue the assets they were going to move. That means that the Senators straight up were just lying about this whole thing. They told the media, hey, no, we're not trading Karlsson. What are you, nuts? We're gonna keep this guy. Hoffman? Nah, he's staying here. Stone? Yeah, nah. He's gonna be a send for life, bro. That's not exactly what he said. Of course, I'm inferencing, but that's the idea. They went out there and they purposefully lied because they wanted to make them more valuable. They wanted other teams to go out there and say, okay, Melnyk, we know you said you're not trading Stone, but here, how about an offer like this? If the Sens came out there and publicly said, yeah, we're trading Stone. We want to trade Hoffman. We want to get rid of Karlsson. Duchene, yeah, he's on the block. That gives other teams the leverage. Other teams all of a sudden hear that and they go up to Melnyk and Dory and they say, hey, bud, you know, we heard you have this guy on the block. Want to negotiate a deal? If it's like that, all of a sudden the teams that want to get these players have the upper hand. Instead, if it's the other way around, where players are like, okay, we know you don't want to trade this guy, but how about we talk about him anyway, that ups the value. It's just, you know, it's kind of weird that he came out here and he publicly said, yeah, I had to lie about this, man. I had to lie to the media and say that we really didn't want to trade these guys just so we could increase their trade value. Like, I get that NHL GMs lie all the time. It happens. Melnyk's not even a GM. He's the owner. We have NHL executives who always say the same things. Oh, PK Subban? Yeah, we're not trading him. Then boom, he gets traded a few weeks later. It happens all the time. But the fact that Melnyk came out here and he said publicly, yeah, I had to lie about it, man. Like, that just rubs me the wrong way. Like, how is anybody supposed to take anything of what he says seriously from here on out? Because all of a sudden there's this record where he's like, yeah, we really wanted to trade these guys. The top six guys on our team, our plan was to trade them all, and look at them, we did it, they're gone. Sorry though, we lied to the media about it. Man, let's continue on with the quotes. Sometimes you just can't tell the true story. You can't tell people, hey, I'm about to move my top six guys. You know what happens. You won't be able to do deals. We got inbound calls that had read a story about how we were rebuilding, and they wondered if maybe Duchene was available. We were able to pull this off very gingerly. We had to be very careful in the way we did it because we were still playing hockey games. You've got these guys that you're trying to move, and they know you're trying to move them. And there was so much going on, you had to balance between telling your fans, this is what I'm doing, and actually executing it, and taking all the heat we got from fans and the sport media. We just had to put our chin up, take all the crap, and in the end of the day, just hope that you're right. If you're right, you're the king of the day, and if you're wrong, you're the bum of the day. Again! What's the point in telling people this? I get that you're being open, but like, how is it beneficial being open about how you lied about stuff? Being open as a GM, as a general manager, as an owner, that's awesome. We love openness out here. But you're being open about what you guys lied about. You were being open about how you were not open in the past. Like, it just makes things a lot weirder, man. Like, oh man, this is such a weird PR move for Eugene Melnyk. Like, I don't even know how to process this. And of course, out of all the GMs and the owners and the executives in the NHL to come out and say something like this, it had to have been Melnyk. Of course. Not like I'm surprised to hear it from him anyway. But there is your confirmation there. When they said they didn't want to move Duchene or Karlsson or Hoffman or Stone or Dzingel or Anisimov or any of the top guys, Dion Phaneuf, I guess, you could say, yeah, they were lying about that. Their plan the entire time was to move it. And we know that for sure because they came out and they said that they lied about that. And from here on out, I'm just so intrigued as to what the plan is going forward, because we still had those comments from a few weeks ago. Yeah, this team's gonna win a cup in the next 4 years. What, you're gonna win a cup when Tim Stützle is 22 years old? That's gonna be awesome, but like, I don't know how realistic it is. You guys are gonna have to make so many more moves. Y'all got a good start earlier this offseason. Tim Stützle, Sanderson, great. Matt Murray, great. Watson, good. Branson, okay, cool. They add size and grit. You have Dadonov, very good player too. We've seen the Sens linked to Corey Perry. How's that gonna go? Not really too sure, but at the end of the day, it just is so funny to me talking about these comments, and I'll leave a link in the description, as always, to the article that we're pulling from Ottawa Sun, because it is very deep. Like, we only covered a few comments and paragraphs in here, but like, there are so many more different angles that are taken on with the Senators, talking about guys like Shabbat, talking about the prospects and the scouting, what exactly they've done so far, the 20-30 year history of the Sens, and Melnyk's 17-year history being the guy who's in charge. So there's a whole bunch of stuff to go over. We just went over one specific part of it that just stood out so incredibly prominently to me, and I hope you got a kick out of this as well. So talk to me in the comments what you think about Eugene Melnyk admitting to the fact that the Sens wanted to trade the six top guys in the organization from day one, admitting the fact that they lied about it to the media, and talking about it as if it's such a cool thing to talk about that, yeah, it's cool to admit that you lied to the media. Okay, I'm gonna go. Talk to me in the comments what you think of me enjoyed this video. Started out Trolls in the 99. And bye.